American Top 40.
The countdown continues and we don't stop until we get to number one.
Number 11.
This is up 7 from last week. At number 11, Dawn and Candida. Candida by Dawn, an American Top 40, and the countdown continues.
American Top 40.
Right now, I have a current huge hit by the group whose lead singer started singing on street corners when he was 12 years old. And before he had turned 17, he'd made the Top 40 twice. Tony Orlando was a solo act in those days, and he says, "I was singing on the streets of New York with a bunch of black kids, and we'd sing doo-wop songs. We didn't get any money thrown at us or anything like that. It was just something we did instead of sports." When he was 16, he went to work for music publisher Don Kirshner, working alongside people like Carol King, Neil Sedaka, and Neil Diamond. Well, it was Carol King who wrote and produced Tony Orlando's first hit, Halfway to Paradise. She also produced his next biggest hit, Bless You, which I said last week she had also written, but that was wrong. Barry Mann and Cynthia Weil wrote Bless You. Anyhow, Tony got cold as a singer after a while and took a job as an executive with a publishing company until several years later when he got talked into singing Candida as lead in a trio called Dawn. Knocked Three Times was their first number one. This was their second. Down this week to number four. Tie a yellow ribbon round the old oak tree. Dawn with Tie a Yellow Ribbon Round the Old Oak Tree. 4 weeks at number one, last week number two, now number four. Three hits to number one and we're counting them down.
The hits from coast to coast.
I have a hit song by a recording act that may have the top record of the year. Their Tie a Yellow Ribbon rode the charts for 23 weeks earlier this year. Here they are with the latest hit at number 29 this week. This is Dawn with Who's in the Strawberry Patch with Sally.
One day happy, one day sad.
Can't take it no more.
Now. Tony Orlando and Dawn at number 29 this week, moving up three notches with Who's in the Strawberry Patch with Sally.
Casey's Coast to Coast.
Well, number 10 in our special countdown of the 40 top artists of the 70s is the trio who kept their identities secret until after their second big hit. Their first release came out in the summer of 1970 and it peaked at number 3. But the group remained a mystery. Their second single hit the charts later the same year and made it all the way to number one. In the meantime, several groups had sprung up around the country, calling themselves Dawn, and getting jobs playing in nightclubs under that identity. Well, finally, the real Dawn burst forth and the phonies just disappeared. The people you'll find at a genuine Dawn recording session are Joyce Vincent, Thelma Hopkins, and Tony Orlando. This was their first number one.
Meet me in the hallway.
Knocked Three Times, Tony Orlando and Dawn at number 10 in our countdown of the 40 top artists of the 70s.
The hits from coast to coast.
Now at number 25, I have a hit by a vocal trio whose first record was a smash. But when they tried to cash in on their success, they couldn't. Because someone else had acquired the legal rights to their name. Back in 1970, three studio singers recorded a song called Candida and released it under the name Dawn. But they were strictly a studio group, and their identity was kept secret by the record label. When their record hit number 3 on the chart, they decided to cash in on the success. But when they tried to accept some of the lucrative bookings that were being offered, they got a big surprise. You see, a super ambitious businessman who knew there was no real group performing under the name saw a chance to make a few fast bucks. He registered the name, put six phony groups on the road, all using the name Dawn. Well, the real group and Bell Records had to recognize the man's legal rights to their name, and they paid $25,000 to buy it back from him. But I guess it was a good investment because here's their 13th chart record that moves up to number 25 this week. Here's the real Dawn and stepping out and gonna boogie tonight. Dawn moves up six notches this week with a song Steppin' Out Gonna Boogie Tonight. Tony Orlando and Dawn at AT40, 24 hits to number one and counting down.
American Top 40.
This is Casey on AT40, and it's time now for the current hit by the singing star whose mentally retarded little sister first turned him on to popular music. Tony Orlando was 10 years old when his sister Rhonda was born. She had cerebral palsy and because of it was mentally retarded. Well, naturally enough, with that age difference, Tony did a lot of babysitting. And what he discovered very early was the effect that music had on Rhonda. Tony says it was the only thing she responded to. He kept the record player going all the time and found that he could cheer her up with some songs and put her to sleep with others. He said, I could even make her stop crying. Eventually, I got a guitar and started picking out tunes and I'd sing to her. And that little girl's response is what inspired the career that later poured out such hits as Halfway to Paradise and Bless You. And later with the group Dawn, Candida, Knock Three Times, and Tie a Yellow Ribbon. This week they're at number 11 with Look in My Eyes, Pretty Woman. Tony Orlando and Dawn. At number 11 for the second consecutive week on American Top 40, Tony Orlando and Dawn with Look in My Eyes, Pretty Woman.
The hits from coast to coast.
Well, now it's time for the number one song of the week. It's by a trio whose lead singer has the formula for success in pop music. The way to make it, he says, is to stick around. He and the two women who make up their trio are now full-fledged stars. They had their own network TV show this past season, and they've been renewed for next season. What led to it, obviously, has been their great success on the charts for the past 5 years. But the lead singer has been sticking around now for 14 years, ever since he hit the charts in 1961 with a couple of ballads, Halfway to Paradise and Bless You. Tony Orlando was a solo act then, and after that initial success in 61, the hits stopped coming. But Tony stuck around in other areas of the business until the opportunity came up in 1970 to record a single with Joyce Vincent and Thelma Hopkins called Candida. And things just kept on getting better and better. And finally they arrived when CBS gave them their own show. Well, their current hit has been in the number one spot for 3 weeks now. Here they are, Tony Orlando and Dawn. Tony Orlando and Dawn and the longest reigning number one record so far this year, the third consecutive week at the top spot. That's He Don't Love You Like I Love You.
American Top 40.
This is Casey Kasem in Hollywood and AT40, and right now I have a debut song by a famous group whose lead singer started out harmonizing on street corners in New York City doing doo-wop songs. That was when he was 12 years old. 4 years later, he had his first Top 40 hit with a song that was written and produced for him by Carole King. The artist was a solo act in those days, and looking back on it now, he says, I was singing on the street corners in New York with a bunch of black kids, and we'd sing doo-wop songs. We didn't get any money thrown at us or anything like that. It was just something we did instead of sports. End of quote. Well, when he was 16, he got a job with music publisher Don Kirshner and began working with people like Carole King, Neil Sedaka, and Neil Diamond. And a short time later, Carole King wrote and produced his first hit, a song called Halfway to Paradise. She also produced his next and biggest hit, Bless You, which got up to number 15 back in 1961. Well, since then, Carole has been busy writing and singing some huge hits of her own. And the former solo artist? Well, he's become the lead singer for one of the most successful groups of the 70s. Moving up this week to number 28 with an old Sam Cooke hit, here is Tony Orlando and Dawn with Cupid. Tony, Thelma, and Joyce at number 28 this week with their latest called Cupid.
American Top 40.
Our special countdown of the 40 biggest recording acts of the 70s continues. Well, like Diana Ross, the lead singer of this next group has also had two separate careers, but the other way around. Tony Orlando started as a solo singer. In 1961, he had two top 40 hits, followed by some non-hits. So he drifted backstage and became an executive with a major label, until he recorded a demo song in 1970. And that demo pushed him back into the spotlight for good. A few months later, the vocal trio that he led had their first number one with a song called Knock Three Times. Here's the 11th biggest recording act of the 70s, Tony Orlando and Dawn.
Knock three times on the ceiling if you want me.
At number 11 in our special countdown on American Top 40 of the 40 top artists of the 70s, Tony Orlando and Dawn with Knock Three Times.
The hits from coast to coast.
Now on American Top 40, let's answer that question about solo singers joining groups. A listener in New York in the Bronx, Preston A. Blocker, writes, "Dear Casey, lots of singers have had successful solo careers after leaving an established group. But what Top 40 solo singer had the most success after joining a group?" Preston, the artist you're looking for, was born in New York City. His mother's Puerto Rican, his father's Greek, and his real name is Michael Cassavetes. As a 17-year-old solo singer back in 1961, he had two Top 40 hits, Halfway to Paradise and Bless You. Then he went into record promotion and music publishing. But in 1970, Michael Cassavetes was asked to record the lead vocal for an act that the company wanted to change from a duo into a trio. He never even met the two women who sang backup. The song, Candida, became a number three smash. Altogether, this trio had 14 Top 40 hits, including three number ones. He Don't Love You, Knock Three Times, and the song that became the anthem for the ex-hostages when they were coming back home, Tie a Yellow Ribbon Round the Old Oak Tree. And that smash became the biggest-selling single of 1973. I'm talking about the trio called Dawn with lead singer Tony Orlando. His real name, Michael Anthony Orlando Cassavetes. And there's your answer, Preston. The Top 40 solo artist who had the most success after joining a group, Tony Orlando, who joined Dawn. Thanks for writing in. Now, on with the countdown.
The hits from coast to coast.